And we now have on the line government's chief negotiator, Miriam Coronel-Ferrer. Good evening, Professor.
Yes, good evening.
Ma'am, negotiations were set to end last Thursday, but they were extended until Saturday. Was there a breakthrough?
Hello.
Professor Ferrer?
Okay, I'm sorry that the sound wasn't very good.
Professor Ferrer, are you there?
Yes, I am. Hello?
Yes.
Hello?
Ma'am? Yes, yeah. Ma'am, we can hear you now. Ma'am, how did the negotiations end over there in Kuala Lumpur?
No, it's still going on. We are in the respective processes to see if we can still find reasons to reconcile the two items that have been left on the table. Mm-hmm. Also, that they will be taking their path very soon, so we'll see what we can still accomplish for today. But right now, we are still in our respective caucuses to figure out how to find a settlement to the issues that are still on the table.
Ma'am, the line is not very clear, but do I understand correctly that there's still two issues on the table still being discussed, and one of these issues would be the wealth sharing annex?
It's all about the wealth sharing annex.
Okay.
And we're discussing, it's all about the wealth sharing annex.
Okay.
And we are discussing the some items left that we need to go still on the annex, and that's where we are.
Mm-hmm. At this point, ma'am, are either side still unwilling to budge? The government is still.
I wouldn't describe it as just like that. You know, what we have been doing is to find creative solutions to some issues that really started off diametrically opposed to each other. So it is in that sense that we are trying to move closer to each other and see ways and means that can satisfy each other's concerns. So that is the kind of process that we are still doing with regard to the two issues left on the table.
Mm-hmm. Ma'am, how do you take this development that at least they have decided or they have agreed to go back to the negotiating table? Because earlier, as of Thursday night, as of Friday, they, the MILF side seemed to be unwilling to even go back to the negotiating table. Is this at the very least a positive development?
I mean, I don't think that neither side will need to go back to the table. The report that said that there was a walkout is totally untrue, because what we did in fact was work overtime every day, despite the fact that we had a recently scheduled 9-to-1 session in consideration of this in the past few months. So there has been no walkout. There have been ups and downs in the negotiations. We settled most items, and now we are left with a few items that we still have to come to terms with.
Mm-hmm. With this process that is ongoing, ma'am, is it possible to set aside first the agreements on the wealth sharing annex and then just move on to the other annexes? Or is this something that, you know, first you have to agree on this before you can move on to the other issues?
Actually, we've been working on the other annexes as well. There was a team here doing work on the power sharing annex as well as on the normalization annex.
Mm-hmm.
So these are, however, less developed than the wealth sharing annex, and that is why we have focused our efforts in the last few days to completing this annex.
Mm-hmm. Are the other two annexes proving to be contentious or as contentious as the wealth sharing annex?
Yes, maybe in different ways, but of course we do have very difficult issues all around, and that's what makes these negotiations difficult. But I guess what's important is that we continue to be flexible and creative. At the end of the day, we cannot get 100%, and the other party as well cannot get 100%. There really has to be that kind of compromises all around.
Mm-hmm. Ma'am, does it add to the pressure on both sides over there, particularly on the side of the Philippine government, that as these negotiations are ongoing, the BIFF is continuously conducting attacks and other such similar atrocities in the South?
Well, certainly that is one of the challenges that has always been part of the negotiations, that there are other groups outside of the party with whom we are negotiating, and that's part of the considerations that both parties are taking into account. But what I can see is that the overall the provisions that we have agreed on certainly provide a very good package. With regards to the ultimate the aim of being able to institute an autonomous government that enjoys fiscal autonomy. So it's really just some of the language that will have to be completed, some of the components that that are contested in terms of what would be part of the fiscal regime that will be voted on tomorrow. But definitely what we already have on the table, where we have consensus, we do have something, a lot of items there that are very, very good. And I would say that compared to even exceed autonomous arrangements that we will find in other parts of the country or even some federal states across the world.
Mm-hmm. Ma'am, the negotiations have already extended beyond the initial schedule. How much longer are you, is this going to go on for another week still?
Right now we're still trying to see what we can accomplish today. But of course, the best news is that we actually sort out the remaining issues and be able to sign the annex. But if that cannot be done, then of course the only alternative is to go home and then to set another date for another meeting.
The way things are going now, are you optimistic that it might still actually happen, that there might still actually be an agreement that will be signed?
Yes, it can go either way.
Right now it can still go either way. All right. Professor Ferrer, thank you very much for joining us.